Hello, I'm Steve. I'm an astronomer at Glasgow Science Centre, and welcome to Stargazing Scotland, introducing you to the night sky from a Scottish perspective. In fact, Scotland has some of the best dark skies anywhere in Europe. Outside on a clear dark night, the sky is ablaze with thousands of stars. It can actually be a little bit overwhelming. In this video, I'll help to make sense of the night sky by introducing you to some of the brightest and easiest things to find. Stars can vary in brightness from the very faintest ones that you strain to see to the brightest stars that can shine through even our light-polluted city skies. There are far more faint stars than bright ones, so let's focus in this video, on the brighter stars. There are fewer of them, and they're much easier to find. When you look up at night, our brains naturally just join the dots. We make a giant dot-to-dot puzzle of the sky. We group stars into imaginary patterns. Astronomers call these patterns constellations. There are 88 official constellations altogether. But as well as the official ones, there are other patterns and pictures that we can see in the night sky. And in Scotland, there are some very famous ones. Let's explore those now. The Plough, also known as the Big Dipper, isn't technically a constellation. It's part of a larger constellation called Ursa Major, the Great Bear. So the Plough is what we call an asterism, and it's visible all year round in Scotland. Another asterism that you might have heard of, which is only visible in Scotland in the winter, is Orion's Belt. These three bright stars line up in the centre of Orion the Hunter. Let's start with the Plough, an excellent asterism to help us find our way around the sky. The Plough is an especially useful asterism to find in the Scottish skies because it helps us locate the North Star. Now, the North Star is not especially bright. Most people think it's famous because it's bright. Actually, it isn't. It's only the 46th brightest star in our sky. So finding it on its own is a bit tricky. But you can use two stars in the Plough, known as the pointers. They join up in a straight line and point you towards the North Star. You can use the Plough to find other things too. Go to the opposite end of the Plough from the pointers, you find a curve of stars, and follow that arc. In the spring, you'll find the bright star called Arcturus. That makes it quite easy to remember. You arc down to Arcturus. Arcturus is a giant red star in the constellation of Bootes the Herdsman. And when it begins to appear in our skies at sunset, we know that spring is on the way. Orion's Belt is another great asterism to explore in the Scottish skies. It sits in the constellation of Orion the Hunter, which is only visible in Scotland in the winter months. But if you can find Orion's Belt, you can find many other interesting things. Just above Orion's Belt are his two shoulders, the left of which is a star called Betelgeuse. Now, Betelgeuse is an Arabic name that in some translations means the soldier's armpit. Go back to Orion's Belt and travel up and to the right, you find the V-shape of the horns of Taurus the Bull. And just beyond that, a beautiful little cluster of stars known as the Seven Sisters, or the Pleiades. Travel in the opposite direction from Orion's Belt, down and left, and you find the brightest star in the night sky, a star called Sirius, the Dog Star. It's always really low in the Scottish skies in the winter. It's a white star, but because it's so low, it twinkles furiously and can appear to change colour. And really, these are just a few of the amazing sights to see in the Scottish skies. Download our Stargazing in Scotland pack for activities you can do at home. Watch our other Stargazing in Scotland videos to find out what else you can see in the night sky. Until next time, don't forget to look up.